Actually, thank you very much indeed. Well, you know, some would say this is the biggest story of the day. In that clip, Simon, we just heard Mr. Jordan say he was given a mandate, he failed to fulfill his mandate. Is that reason enough for him to go?
I just think it's odd that they keep using the word mandate. It's kind of a media buzzword. I asked Gordon Negesson that question on numerous occasions, especially when we were still in contention for the 2014 World Cup qualification, and he always debunked the myth of this mandate. I think on the face of it, going into his tenure as the coach, it was always perhaps a little bit foolish to be talking about such things as mandates. The very first thing he had to do was clean up Pitsa Mosimane's mess, basically, and try and get us to Brazil. He couldn't get us to Brazil, even though he only lost one match in terms of his qualification, but it was those two draws early on in the campaign that really cost him. And after everything is said and done, he didn't get a proper crack at qualifying for the World Cup.
So he should have been given more time, you say. So SAFA have huge ambitions. They're going to spend money to bring in another coach. Anecdotally, perhaps, a social website did a poll and they said who should take over. 70% said nobody could save Bafana Bafana. So is it a coach issue, or do you think that there are bigger problems in South African football?
Well, that's exactly it. Is it a coach issue? I don't think it is a coach issue. Gordon Negesson was perfect for the position. He understood the football. He was very successful in the PSL, four titles with four different clubs. He was spot on. He never ever got the squad he wanted when he needed that squad. First of all, let's just say that. He never got the players he needed. Does any other team coach in the world have that kind of problem? Does Roy Hodgson have that problem? It defies belief that, you know, you can expect so much of a guy and then not give him what he needs to perform. Is the coach the problem? I don't think the coach is the problem. I think that there is a bigger problem. And until that problem gets sorted, until all the cooks in the kitchen get told, you know, leave and let this guy now just orchestrate things, then it's always going to be the case.
Again, looking at Twitter, looking at social media, people are pointing fingers at SAFA. Is it they that should be getting their house in order? I mean, we're talking about 23 coach changes in 22 years. I don't know any team that's ever done that.
I think public opinion is spot on right now. They're not buying the fact that, you know, Gordon failed at this. Then they're tired of having to see another coach come in, having another coach set up for failure, because that's essentially what happened to Gordon Negesson. He was set up for failure. When he was given full control of stuff, when he was allowed the players that he needed, when the PSL clubs were told you better just give the players out, then everything was fine. But if we base it on the fact that he failed at Chan, that's a second tier continental competition. That doesn't mean anything, seriously.
So what needs to happen to fix South African football?
I don't know, a miracle probably, because if we get a high-paid big gun into this job, like we've done in the past, like we got Carlos Alberto Pereira, will he understand the landscape? Will he put up with all the politics, the meddling? Will he stand for any of that? Because he needs to be given space and be told, right, you're the captain of this ship, now you take us forward. Until that happens, who's going to want that kind of job?
Why the impatience, do you think, that these changes are so frequent?
I think SAFA came in with a new ethos when Danny Jordan came in, and they said, right, listen, we need to be professional, we need to be top-tier country, we need to be all of this, and we need it now, right now. But I don't know if it's addressing the endemic problems in the organization, in the structure, in the structures of South African football, in the fact that the domestic league is essentially running the national game, and SAFA's hands are sort of tied when it comes to this kind of stuff. And yes, rightly so, the public expects, the public wants the coaches there to provide, and we have coaches with those credentials, and Gordon Negesson is one of those coaches with those credentials. But there's many other factors going on, and you know he had to bite his tongue plenty of times.
All right, so we're going to have to leave it there, Simon. Thank you very much indeed.